When thinking about Windows Virtual Desktop security, there are several areas to keep in mind, and that's because WVD spans technologies from Azure infrastructure to the platform services and our user identities. And since WVD is accessible from any device anywhere in the world and anyone can claim to be one of your users, we need to be able to prove that they are who they say they are and that those identities have not been compromised. Also, you may want to have different conditions in place that enable you to treat users differently if they're on your corporate network or VPN versus sitting at the local coffee shop. So join us for the next few minutes as we dig into identity security as part two of this micro series on securing Windows Virtual Desktop. I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy. The modern security perimeter extends beyond your network to include user identities, and so we need to secure them so that when someone tries to log in to WVD, they are appropriately challenged to prove they are who they're claiming to be and they should be granted access. So let's go over to the Azure Docs. And in the Azure Docs, we're going to scroll down a little bit, and then the table of contents, we'll go to Identity, then go to Azure Active Directory. We're in this top link to secure your remote workforce. So the two things that we're going to be highlighting today is multi-factor authentication and conditional access. Let's start with MFA. We'll click this link for how does MFA work. And basically, MFA is that two-factor authentication. It's where we tie our user identity of username and password together with some other kind of authentication. It's just some other way to prove that you are who you say you are when you go to log in. So multi-factor has been around for quite a long time. And today for Azure, the most common ways of doing multi-factor auth is with your smartphone having an authenticator app on it or receiving a text message. And there's a couple different ways that you can implement MFA, and we're going to talk through those today. But where MFA really starts to shine is when we combine it with conditional access. Now, conditional access is where we set rules and policies in our organization that say when you go to log in, do we require you to put in MFA? So if you're signing in from a computer that is in your office, so you may not require MFA or other rules during those conditions. But if you're logging in from somewhere just off the internet, then we need to have some better proof that you are you. So we might challenge you then with MFA. Now, of course, you can go much deeper on each of these topics. We're just going to cover them in relation to virtual desktop today. But if you're interested in a deeper dive on conditional access or other Azure Active Directory security, give me some comments below on what you're interested in, and we'll be happy to make a video for you. Back to the main page of the Azure Docs, we'll go down to the virtual desktop documentation. And in the search filter on the left, we'll type in multi-factor and click the link for the multi-factor auth doc. And this is going to walk us through our process for today's video. So we'll scroll down just a little bit to this prerequisites section, because in order to use something like conditional access, we do have to have an Azure Active Directory P1 or P2 license. Now, MFA is slightly different because MFA is free, but you only get some of the advanced MFA features with conditional access when you have P1, P2 licenses. So over in the Azure portal, we'll go to Azure Active Directory, and then we'll go to our users. And at the top here, there's a quick link to go to multi-factor authentication. And enabling multi-factor auth is as simple as checking the box and then clicking enable for any one or multiple of our users. And of course, it's suggested to read the deployment guide before you go ahead and do this. And certainly before you do this for every single user, there are other things to consider first. So we'll come right back to here in a minute. Back in the Azure portal, let's assume for a second, what if you set up MFA and conditional access on all of these users? And now let's ask the question, for argument's sake, what if something went wrong with the MFA service? What if you couldn't multi-factor? That would lock everybody out of using WVD and probably lock everyone out of Azure altogether. That would be an absolutely terrible thing. So to avoid that, it is a good best practice to create a Azure cloud account that will not have MFA, conditional access, privileged identity management, or any other features enabled. It will be considered a backdoor account. So that way, in case something goes wrong, you have a way to get back into the system and unlock users and keep them going. Now, with setting up something like this, it is also a best practice that no one person have the password. The password should be divided amongst multiple people so no one person can log in on their own, or it should be stored in a password vault that people have to go through a unlock process to be able to get to those credentials. Kind of like break the glass in case of emergency. So to set up an account like this, we can just go up to the top, click add new user, and this would be a create user operation. And I'll call this user backdoor, fill out the name, first name, and last name. And then I've set a password. For the groups, we do not want any groups selected, but for the roles, we're gonna change from being a user to the global administrator role. And we'll hit select for that. And the block sign in here, of course, should be no. And then you can lock it down to the specific country of origin where this account should be used from. So in my case, I'll select United States. And then we go ahead and hit create. And there we can see our new backdoor administrator account. With that out of the way, we can now return to MFA and know that if something goes wrong, we still have a way to get back in and re-enable our users. So I'll select several of our users here and then click enable. And then click enable multi-factor auth. And we see that those users are now enabled. Now, if we use our search filter up here, we change from any to those who are enabled. And then there are all of those currently enabled users. But if we switch to enforced, we see that we do not have any yet. Enforced means that we are requiring MFA. Enabled means that you have turned on MFA for these users, but it's not yet configured. And then when I go to sign in to something like the web portal or the WVD client, I give my username as normal, provide my password, and then I click sign in. Now they're presented with this screen that more information is required. So we'll click next. Now each individual user can choose their authentication method. So you can choose here a phone, which will send them a text, or a mobile app, in which case they'll be needing the Microsoft Authenticator. So I'll just choose a phone number in this case and hit next. And then it's going to send a text to my phone number. And I supply the verification code and click verify. And we are done. Additionally, you can set up an application password through this link over here so that for things like signing into Outlook or your other Office products, you don't have to provide this challenge authentication because the app itself is responsive to that challenge. In this case, I'll just click done and we are signed into the app because our MFA challenge was accepted. And since I've now enabled MFA, when I open my client application and I go to log in, I'm now asked to represent my credentials. And there's my MFA challenge. You put in your code and hit verify, and the rest of our sign-in process completes as normal. So now let's kick things up a notch and add some conditional access. Now, as we talked about in the beginning, conditional access is one of those advanced features in Azure AD, so we need a license for this. So we see licenses over here on the left, and the first thing we have is getting started with license management. So I'll go over here on the right to get a free trial. And we have two different services to pick from. The Premium P2 licenses will give us every feature possible. And then the Enterprise Mobility section above that will be P2, but also give you some Office 365 functionality. I'll open up the free trial here for the EMS licenses, because why not? And click activate. Now that that's enabled, we can go to license features and see everything that we have now enabled, along with a learn more link in the center for each one of those features so that you can always figure out what these features do. And over on the left, we'll go to all products, and there you can see is our EMS license for 250 users. So we'll check the box here to go to assign it, and we'll click the users link here. So we'll add several of our users and hit select, and then we have to pick their assignment option. And at this point, there's no reason why we shouldn't select everything, and we'll hit OK for that. And then when we go to assign, you might have a problem. So in this case, my licenses are not assigned, and the reason why is it says that we cannot assign licenses without usage locations specified. So if you haven't had to set some of the information around your users, if they were just synced over from your Active Directory, and you had never set up these fields, then your users are also going to have this problem. So inside the user Hulk, if we scroll down, we see our usage location is blank. So we'll hit edit up here at the top, select our usage location, and this is going to become important for conditional access in particular, and we'll hit save. Now that we've done that, over here on the left under licenses, we can do an assignment now for our E5, selecting all of our services and hitting save, and now that license has been assigned successfully. Now, obviously, we don't want to have to do this for every single user by hand. What if you have hundreds or thousands of them? So we can make this easier with PowerShell. And there's two basic ways that we could script this out. This way is going to be using a sync rule through Azure AD Connect, and you can certainly do this if you like. But if that looks too complicated, don't worry. There's an easier way to do it. First thing we have to do is connect to Azure AD. So I'll run that and we'll log in. And with that out of the way, the command is very simple. It's set dash Azure AD user, passing the object ID of our UPN, in this case, Thor, and then setting the usage location as US. And we run that. And then we can run the get dash Azure AD user and then select all the properties. And at the bottom here, you can see our usage location is now US. We're going to run this through a for each loop. So I'll run this next command, which is going to give me every user in my environment that does not have Microsoft in the name. And that's because there are some accounts that are on Microsoft.com accounts, and we don't want those. So here are all of the UPNs, and they look good to me. So now we'll run the next part, which is the for each loop, and that is done. And of course, we can verify that back in the Azure portal and open up Gamora and scroll down just a little bit, and there is our usage location as United States. So now we can successfully add an assignment for the E5 license to Gamora and hit save, and that's done. We're back in the overview. We'll now scroll down in the blade to security, and then first we'll go to named locations. So if I go into Azure here, you'll notice that these are the IP address ranges for my Azure private virtual networks, and they're also marked as a trusted location. And we can do that by IPs, or we could do it by countries, but it will allow us to add certain other global rules. So I've selected the 5 countries for our global offices, and we'll hit create. But notice that this is not trusted because we cannot possibly trust every IP address in a single country. And I've also added untrusted locations as well. And at the top here, we can start by creating a new policy. So we'll call this policy WBD and then select our users. And I'll choose to select users and groups. So in this case, I'll just select these 4 users and hit select. Then we can also add excludes here. And I'll choose the same users and groups. And I'll select my admin here. We'll hit done for that. And then we have to select our cloud app. We'll choose select apps, and I'll just type in Windows Virtual Desktop. And you can see we've got a few options. And here is why. Because we have the non-ARM and the ARM versions available now, we have these multiple choices. So the one that's related to the new ARM portal or the spring update would be this second one. It's the one that starts with 9CD and ends in D07. And that's covered in our documentation. We'll come back and do the other one in just a moment. We can keep these rules separate. So we'll hit select for that, then hit done. Now you can select some conditions if you want to. And the conditions can be tied to many different factors. One would be a sign-in risk. How risky does this sign-in attempt appear? What is the specific type of device a user is coming from? What are the locations that they're coming from? Then we have 2 new features here around client apps and device states. So under locations, I'll choose yes for this, and I'll select my locations, and we can see the ones from our named locations. And for this rule, I'll just select Azure as well as my on-prem, and we'll hit select for that and hit done there. And that's all I'm going to configure here. And under access controls, we'll click on that. And here we want to grant access and require multi-factor authentication, and we'll hit select for that. And under session, we'll select sign-in frequency, and then we have to select the units here, and that is hours or days. The shortest time span that we can set this policy for is 1 hour, so you'll get prompted right now through conditional access to submit your MFA token. Then if you sign out 20 minutes later and you go to sign back in, you would not be re-challenged for MFA. Now, of course, you can then expand this out to days as well, and so depending on your location policy, where these users are coming from, you may want this to be extremely restrictive or not have them prompt for MFA at all, which is another rule set that we can get into in a minute. So I'll have this go for 1 hour, and I'll hit select for that. And then we have the policy enable feature, and this is where we can choose to have this just be a learning tool at the moment, just have it report only, or we can enable this policy, which will enforce these settings, or we could just turn this policy off if something is not working correctly, or we want to retire the policy. So I'll set the policy to on, and we'll hit create. And we can do this from a different place as well. So back in the overview, if we go to our enterprise applications and we scroll down, we've got Windows Virtual Desktop here. This is the non-ARM registration that we had done. We can click on our client, and then over here on the left, go to conditional access, and we're basically in the same place. Set our policy, go go to select our specific users or groups. In this case, I'll choose an Azure AD group. We've already got our applications selected, and then you can set your conditions. And for locations, I'll just choose all trusted locations this time. Under grant, we'll set it for multi-factor authentication. And for our session frequency, this time I'll make this for 1 day. And this policy I'm going to set just as report only. So now back to the main page of Azure AD, we'll go back to security, back to conditional access, and we can see both policies are here and what their current status is. So now that we've configured the policy, I'm going to go to my app here and I'm going to unsubscribe myself. That way I should be asked to log in again. We'll go to subscribe and it wants to know our user identity. So I'll put in my credentials and hit next and provide my password. And we'll hit sign in and we're prompted for our MFA. And we'll click verify, and we are signed in. So now right away, I'm going to unsubscribe again, and then go right back in, and it resubscribed me without having to provide my MFA credentials at all, because I have already signed in, and I've got 1 hour before that expires. And I'll open the web browser version, and without having to provide my challenge to MFA at all, I am instantly able to sign in. However, if I go to an in private browser and I do the same thing, now I have to provide my credentials. And now I'm being challenged again for MFA because even though I've provided those credentials within the last hour, this is a different device essentially because it is a private browser. And so it is not yet trusted. So I can go ahead and verify, and now I'm in. Let's go back to our conditional access policy now. So let's go and create a new policy. And for this one, we'll click to enable the new preview experience. We'll give it the name of untrusted location for WBD, and we'll set our users to be all users. We will add one exclusion for our WBD admin, just in case. For our client app, we'll do the same select we did before. And in this case, we'll just select all of the virtual desktop apps and hit select. And the conditions, we'll choose a selected location of untrusted locations and hit select for that. And under the grant rules, we're going to block access. We don't need to select a sign-in frequency since we're blocking things here. And we'll choose to enable this policy and hit create. So now any user coming from an untrusted location will now be blocked. And for my IP location details, I'm appearing as though I'm in Singapore, which is not one of my trusted locations. And we'll go to sign in again, provide our password. And we do not get the MFA challenge, but we do get a message saying that we can't sign in because we don't meet the criteria necessary to be able to do that. And there is a more details link. And we can see at the bottom here our troubleshooting details. In case you reach this message in error, you can give that to your IT folks who should be able to help sort that out. Back in the Azure portal, we can also scroll down here to the monitoring section. And if you haven't done this already for your Azure AD, you definitely should. Go to your diagnostic settings and make sure that your sending your Azure AD logs to Log Analytics or somewhere else so that you can track and monitor what's going on. And when you do, you can go into sign in. We can see all of the different logins that have happened, what their status was, success or failure, what their locations were, and you can click on any of the users if you want to grab more details. We can see from the location that same public IP address, and under the conditional access rules, we have the report only rule for the non-ARM WBD, as well as the conditional access rules for WBD and untrusted locations. And these are just showing you all the rules applied to this user as a whole. To see the particular details around this login, you go to authentication details. We can see access has been blocked due to conditional access policies. So I hope that you've enjoyed looking at how we could secure our users in our WBD environments through multi-factor authentication as well as conditional access. This was not an exhaustive look at either one of these features. There's a lot more to be told. And if you're interested in that, give me some comments down below and we can dive deeper on this subject. So if you like this video or learned something new today, go ahead and hit the thumbs up icon and join us here at the Azure Academy if you haven't done so already by clicking that subscribe button. And while you're down there, leave me a question or a comment on what you thought about this video or any questions that you have on Azure in general. If I don't know the answer, I probably know someone who does. And you can also leave us a comment on some videos that you'd like us to create for you. And maybe you'd like to receive an email notifying you when our new videos come out, which is about once a week. You can click the email notification bell there as well. And check out our latest video over here on the top right, as well as another one at the bottom we picked out just for you to help you keep learning about Azure. Thanks for joining us for this second video in this micro series on securing WBD, and we will catch you in the next one. Happy learning.